With the world's group stage starting out like we've all been waiting for, we here at SK Gaming thought it would be nice to go over some of the most contested picks that have been seen lately. And some of these are likely to stay throughout the whole world. But today we'll be focusing mainly on what's been the main show of world so far. Namely the 97% pick ban rate on Miss Fortune and her 55% win rate throughout it all. And kind of on the same side of the show, we'll also be focusing on Leona's 79% win rate over 24 games. What's up with that? Well, I'm here to explain some of the reasoning behind this. First of all, let's clear up a few things right away. Miss Fortune has been buffed recently, meaning what was previously 12, 14, and 16 waves across her ultimate has now become 14, 16, and 18. Which what actually means is that her level 6 ultimate has now become a level 11 ultimate, well, in terms of waves at least. And that's a pretty big buff. And this change was implemented in patch 11.18. But 11.19 came, and not much has been changed in terms of Miss Fortune. But this buff to her ultimate is by far not the only reason why she's being so picked in Worlds. That's actually something that MF has always been good at, and it has nothing to do with the previous patch. And that is that she is an extremely aggressive early game lane bully, and perhaps one of the only lanes that, besides Lucian, can actually counter Ziggs's Lost Chapter power spike. Yes, the buff in the last patch notes has actually been enough to increase her flat 50% win rate to a 52% win rate across solo queue, but not everything that works in solo queue also works in pro play. I'm looking at you, Singed mains. Fact is, two of the most picked AD carries recently have been Aphelios and Varus in terms of pro play. Both have really interesting damage output and scale rather well into the late game. They also have CC in their kits, and also especially Varus can thrive off of lethality, which is pretty big right now. But these two champions have actually been taking nerf after nerf with each patch that comes. 11.18 has decreased both Varus and Aphelios' base AD, and with 11.19, Varus' Q cooldown has actually also been increased, meaning that his arrows are actually coming at a much lower rate, especially when this ability is maxed out. Aphelios has one of the problems of not scaling that well with lethality, making him a pretty solid second or third pick. But the first option has by and large been taken by the one and only Miss Fortune. Now, it's quite unfair to even stand them on the same pedestal, as Aphelios and MF kind of serve different roles for the team that picks them, but they're both AD carries, right? I've also been mentioning the Ziggs AP carry meta, which is actually also a really nice possibility, and we'll probably see some of those in the world's meta. But the problem right now with Ziggs is that his role in a team is to be a lane bully and to dominate his lane over his opponents, especially in the early game, mainly with incessant poke. And he also has a pretty big power spike compared to most ADCs when he goes back to buy Lost Chapter, which is really incredible sustain for him. The thing with MF is that she is actually a pretty good counter to his lane, not only because of her increased movement speed to dodge most of Ziggs's skill shots, but she can actually match this back for Lost Chapter with a back for Vampiric Scepter, which she will actually use pretty early on when she builds Eclipse, and this added lifesteal can actually help her replenish whatever HP she loses due to being hit with poke. And due to MF being such a high pick priority, do you want to guess how many times Ziggs bot lane has been played? So far with the initial groups games and the play-ins, Ziggs has been picked 0 times. He's only been banned 3 times, potentially due to the fact that teams are either playing MF or preparing to play against MF. Keep in mind, the usual Ezreal and Draven are also potential picks, but they're being banned way more often. But now let's actually shift our focus into Leona a bit, shall we? 79% win rate over 24 games. What even is that? Well, the thing about Leona right now is that she is a great pick to pick with MF or against MF as well, which makes her an awesome pick to be picked most games that we've seen so far. She has a 49% win rate in solo queue overall, but it actually climbs to 50% and higher in Masters and above. But what's actually more important for the Leona pick to work is a team that synergizes well with her, and not a bunch of solo queue one-trick ponies picking whatever they want in every single team. She is actually not in need of a major buff or a major nerf, so we'll most likely be seeing her for a while in Worlds. And the only reason why she has a kind of low win rate in solo queue is that most people in solo queue are actually preferring damage over sustain and tankiness and utility and whatever. Solo queue dominant champions are Zyra and Brand, not Leona and Alistar. But these last two can actually shine really well if they only have a team that actually synergizes with them and can use their engage, like most teams at Worlds do. This, coupled with the fact that she's one of the most naturally tanky champions in the meta right now, makes it so that her laning phase is never uneventful. Brace yourselves, my boys. Leona's about to join Rakan and Thresh with a second world skin. I hope you've enjoyed this little deep dive into one of the world's metas. You'll most likely be seeing more of these kinds of videos, but let us know in the comments if you do like this content or if you'd like to see something else, especially regarding League of Legends Worlds. It's been really fun hanging out with you. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.